through the Pacific Division, the Black and White Battalion found themselves with the 8th seed in the Western Conference. Their opponents in the first round of the Stanley Cup playoffs wound up being the top team in the league, the Vancouver Canucks. Things started badly in Game 1 when Alex Burrows drew first blood when he put the Canucks on the board early. But later in the period, the Commando from Kenora, Mike Richards, tied the game when he fired a laser past Roberto Luongo for a power play goal. Then it was Sweet Willie Mitchell who shot a long-range missile past Luongo for the Kings' second power play goal of the game. That's when the Canucks started to get desperate. Bryon Bitz crushed Kyle Clifford into the boards to send a message to the Lords of Los Angeles. Then Alexander Edler followed up with a game-tying score when his shot flew past Jonathan Quick to make it 2-2. But the Kings were undeterred. The Manitoba miscreant Dustin Penner made his presence felt when he caught Luongo by surprise by scoring off escape pass from Jeff Carter to give the Kings a 3-2 lead. Then it was Captain America, Dustin Brown, who capped it off by popping the puck into the empty net to leave the crowd at Rogers Arena stunned. The battle picked up 2 days later as the Royal Army looked to fortify their position with another win. And this time it was the Kings who struck first when in a Slovenian stunner, Andrzej Kopitar intercepted the puck and drove to the net. The puck was knocked away but found its way to Dustin Brown, who picked the top corner to deposit a shorthanded goal to give the Kings a 1-0 lead. But Yannick Hansen kept the Canucks in the game when his goal early in the second period seemingly caught the Kings off guard. But our boys soon recovered thanks to the leadership of Dustin Brown. Cap scored another shorthanded goal 5 minutes later to give the lead back to Los Angeles. Then in a mad scramble in front of Luongo, the sergeant from Saskatchewan, Jared Stoll, slipped the puck past Luongo to put Los Angeles up 3-1. Stoll's goal seemed to light a fire under Vancouver as things started to get chippy. But rather than get suckered into a slobber knocker, the Kings just laughed it off. They added insult to injury later when the Salt Lake Monster, Trevor Lewis, scored to put the nail in the coffin for Game 2. The victory allowed the Kings to return home to the City of Angels, up 2 games in the series. In an effort to shake things up, Vancouver decided to switch netminders, going with Ori Schneider over Roberto Luongo in Game 3. However, the Kings' Captain America, Dustin Brown, continued his hot streak, scoring his 4th goal of the series on a huge rebound to give the Kings an early lead. All season long, the Royal Regiment could rely on their last line of defense, goaltender Johnny Quick, when they needed him most. And in Game 3, Quick proved why he was most deserving of all the accolades. The mercenary from Milford, Connecticut, turned away all 41 shots he faced, securing a 1-0 shutout in Game 3 and setting up a potential sweep of the league's top team. With blood in the water, the Kings attacked with reckless abandon early in Game 4. And it was the Slovenian stunner, Andrzej Kopitar, who put the Kings on the board with a dandy play. But Vancouver was able to claw their way back. They got goals from Alexander Edler, Kevin Bieksa, and Henrik Sedin to give the Canucks a 3-1 lead. Canucks netminder Corey Schneider also stood firm, turning away 43 shots and allowing the Canucks to avoid the sweep and sending the series back to their home ice in Vancouver. With the series hanging in the balance in Game 5, the Canucks showed some playoff pluck as Henrik Sedin scored a power play goal to give Vancouver an early lead. But the Royal ranks rallied, and it was the banger from Belleville, Brad Richardson, who slid the puck past his shackled Schneider to even the score. With the goals knotted at 1, the battle was extended to extra frames, and it didn't take long for the Kings to pounce on an opportunity. The sergeant from Saskatchewan, Jared Stoll, shot a wrister past Schneider for the series-winning goal, sending the President's Cup trophy-winning Canucks back to the locker room with their tails between their legs. And while the Saints of Los Angeles reveled in their first playoff series victory in over a decade, the war is far from over. The road to Lord Stanley's Chalice now lies through the great arch of St. Louis. The Royal Regiment will need to be more cunning and deadly if they hope to stay in the hunt. Only time will tell to see if the Kings can avoid singing the blues.